Okay, so welcome to the fourth lecture of the series Unreal Engine 5 for RQuest, and today we will continue our modeling process and I will create a window through this wall and then we will start working on our interiors and I will model a bookshelf for this living room. Okay, so let's begin. Let's select this mesh and I will go into the edit mode. Let's select all of these vertices and I will snap them up to this point. Okay. Let's select this mesh and I will create a loop cut. Select these vertices and I will snap them up to this point. Now I will select this mesh again. I will select these vertices and let's move them in Z direction by 0.2 meters. Let me select this mesh again. I will create a loop cut. Snap it up to this point. Select these four vertices and I will extrude and snap them up to this point. Okay, now I don't need this mesh, so I will delete it. Okay, let's go into the top view and I will go into the wireframe mode and I will add a single vertex to start working on my window frame. Extrude and snap. Extrude and merge. Yes. Let's select all of these vertices and I will snap them up to this point. Okay, now let's extrude them in Z direction up to this point. Let me go into the face selection mode. Let's select this face and I will select this face and I will insert these faces to about 0.05 meters and I'll then delete those faces. Let's isolate this mesh. We first select the edge selection mode and I will select these edges and press F. Okay, so now I will disable my snapping and I will create a loop cut inside this frame. Let me separate it by selection. I will select this loop and I will fill in these edges. Okay, so let's select this wall and I will select these edges and press F. Okay, now I will select this mesh and I will divide it to make it less complex. And I will separate this one and I will select these vertices and separate it by selection. Okay, so now as you can see that these three are different objects. Okay, so let me delete this face because I don't need that. Okay, so now we will start working on our interiors and I will model a bookshelf for this living room. Okay, so let's go into the top view, add a single vertex and I will snap it up to this point. Let me first enable snapping and let's snap up to this point and I will extrude that in X axis to about 0.215 meters in negative direction. I will select these two vertices and I will extrude them in Y direction and I will type in 0.025 meters. Okay. I will select this plane and I will place it somewhere around here, I guess. Let's extrude this in Z direction to about 0.8 meters. Okay, now I will set origin for this to geometry. Okay, so now I will select this mesh. Let me enable my gizmo. I will make a copy. I will press Shift D and I will move this in Y direction. I will rotate this about X axis 90 degrees and I will snap it up to this point. Then I will snap it in Y direction up to this point. Let me just move this and place it somewhere around here. Yes. Okay, now let's go into the edit mode. Select these four vertices. Let me first enable edge length. Okay. And I will move this in y direction until the edge length becomes 2.13 meters. Okay. Let me disable the snapping. GY. And I will make this edge length to about 2.13 meters. Yes. Let's select this mesh. I'll press Shift D and I will drag this in Y direction. And I will snap it up to this point. Let me enable the snapping again. I will snap up to this point. I will select this one and I will extrude and snap up to this point, and then I will extrude it again. And I will make the length of this edge to about 2.13 meters. Yes. Now I will select this one again and I will make another copy. Press Shift D, move it in Y direction, and I will place it right here. Okay, so I will select this mesh again. I will make a copy and I will snap it at this point. So now I will select these three meshes, this one and this one. I will go into the edit mode, select the bottom vertices, and I will snap them up to this point. Yes. Okay, now I will select this mesh. I will make a copy and I will move this in Z direction to about 0.325 meters and I will press Shift R to repeat the same process. Okay. So now I will select this mesh and this mesh, go into the edit mode, select these vertices, and I will move them in Y direction. I will snap them up to this point. Yes. I will do the same thing here as well. I will select these vertices, GY, and yes. Okay, so now I will create a few loop cuts. Okay. Yes, let's create a loop cut and snap it right here. Let's create another loop cut and I will snap it right here. Let's create another one and I will snap it right here, and I will create another one and I will snap it right here. Yes. Okay, so now I will select these vertices and I will press P to separate them by selection. Okay. Now I will select this mesh and I will select these bottom four vertices and I will delete these vertices. Okay. I will go into the edit mode again and I will separate these vertices. Then I will select this mesh and delete these top four vertices. As you can see that these three are now different objects. Okay, so now our bookshelf is ready. Very soon we will be placing some books in these racks. We will download free 3D models from different websites and we will place those books into these racks. Okay, that's it for this lecture and I will see you guys in the next one.